In this video, I'm going to be answering these binomial distribution questions using BINOM.DIST.RANGE function in Excel or Google Sheets. The function requires the number of trials, the probability of success, the starting number or lower limit, and the ending number or upper limit, inclusive. For this problem, the number of trials n equals 8, and the probability of success p equals 1 over 5 or 0.2. For exactly 3 successes, type equals binom, select the second option from the drop-down. Input 8 for the number of successes, comma, 0.2 for the probability of success, comma, then 3 for the starting number of successes. You see here that the second success number is in brackets, telling us that it is optional. So we can enter and obtain the result. Note that for exactly 1 point, you can also set both lower and upper limits to the same value. I'm going to use equals formula text to show the formula used in those cells here. Color it green and drag it down to the second cell here. For part B, all questions incorrectly means 0 successes. So equals binom dist range 8, 0.2, 0. I'm going to drag down the formula text function for that too. For C, at least one question correctly means we have a lower limit of 1 and an upper limit of the maximum possible, which is 8. We can also use the fact that the probability of at least 1 equals 1 minus probability of 0. So we can do 1 minus the result from part B. I'll copy the formula text function from B to C. For part D, at most 2 questions correctly means maximum 2. So we go from 0 to 2 successes. I'll drag down the formula text again. For E, at least 2 but no more than 5 means we're going from 2 to 5. Copy the formula, paste for E. Part F. For more than 1 and less than 4, only 2 and 3 are included. So we have a lower limit of 2 and an upper limit of 3. For G, more than 2 and less than 3. Since binomial is a discrete distribution, there is no value between 2 and 3 exclusive, so the probability is 0. For H, less than 2 or more than 4 requires us to add up the probabilities for the successes below 2 to those above 4. Or we can use the complement rule. That is, 1 minus the probability of going from 2 to 4, which will give the same result. For I, we cannot have less than 2 and more than 5 at the same time, so the probability is 0. I'm going to copy and paste the formula text function again here. Lastly, for j, between 2.2 and 5.4. If you use these values as they are, Excel simply gets rid of the decimal part and returns the result from 2 to 5, as you can see up here. But that would be incorrect, since 2 is not included in the stated range. The whole number included in the specified range are 3, 4, and 5. Thus, we change the lower limit to 3 and the upper limit to 5. And that gives the required result. And that's it for this video. Please drop your comments and questions in the chat. Thanks for watching.